Assalamualaikum and good day everyone. Welcome back to your fourth week of your lecture in PhD 612 Pharmacology of Drugs Affecting the Endocrine System. And this week we will cover the adrenocorticosteroids and adrenocortical antagonists. As you can see here, the name of adrenocorticosteroids that will be covered today is comprising of the words of adrenal cortex and steroids. As let's recap back what you have been learned in the anatomy and physiology. The adrenal cortex is one of the layers beside the adrenal medulla in the adrenal gland. As you can see in the picture, adrenal gland is located in the top region of your kidney. So that means that adrenocorticosteroids is a steroid molecule that been produced and released by the adrenal cortex naturally in our body system. The lack of this hormone in our body will cause the Addison disease, and it's too much or excess production of it can cause Cushing syndromes. So these two diseases we'll cover next in our next video. As usual, at the end of this lecture, you should be able to review the feedback mechanism in the HPA axis, which is the hypothalamus, pituitary, and adrenal axis, and discuss the physiology of adrenal gland function as it relates to the corticoid synthesis. And in the next video, you will need to explain the pharmacokinetics and the mechanism of action of it. And the next video, we will discuss on the pharmacology and review the therapeutic applications of available steroid preparation. In the last video, we will discuss on the mineralocorticoids and adrenocortical antagonists and their pharmacological use. Let's discuss the first topic, which is the adrenocorticosteroids. As I mentioned earlier, adrenocorticosteroids is compounds that are created by the adrenal cortex. There are three types of compounds that are created by the adrenal cortex. Name it as a glucocorticoids, mineralocorticoids, and androgens. So we will discuss the hypothalamic pituitary or an adrenal axis, or known as HPA axis. Please have a look at the picture here first. It's comprising two organs, namely the brain, which consists of the hippocampus, the hypothalamus, as well the anterior lobe of the pituitary glands. And another one organ is your adrenal glands, which consists of the adrenal cortex layer. So this adrenal cortex, the one that responsible to produce the adrenocorticosteroids that regulated by this HPA axis. So the words of HPA axis, as I mentioned earlier, referring to the hypothalamic, pituitary, and adrenal axis, they involve of complex sex of interactions between this part of the organs, which is the hypothalamus, the pituitary gland, and adrenal gland to produce the adrenal corticosteroids. As you can see here, the cortisol, okay, is a natural glucocorticoid, okay, that produced naturally in our body through these circadian regulations. Okay, so the production of cortisol is diurnal. It means that what's the meaning of the diurnal? As you can see in this picture, okay, the production of the cortisol referring to high peak in early morning and another small peak in the late afternoon. So if you have stress, physical or emotional, it also can trigger the production of cortisol. Besides that, lack of glucose in our body, or known as hypoglycemia, as I mentioned in earlier in last week lecture. Besides that, the pain, fever, or cold also may trigger the production of cortisol. So the stress response can trigger the paraventricular nucleus, okay, of the hypothalamus that contain neuroendocrine neuron to release the hormone which known as corticotropin releasing factor, or CRH. Okay, so this CRH will stimulate the anterior lobe of the pituitary gland to secrete the adrenocorticotropic hormone, or also known as ACTH. So I would like to talk about this. ACTH is derived from the pro-opiomelanocortin, or known as POMC. So this POMC is the large protein that synthesized in the pituitary. So the breakdown of POMC not only release the ACTH, it also can release some segments such as melanocyte stimulating hormone, or known as MSH. This MSH is important because it can regulate your appetite and your pigmentation in your skin. That is why when you are in stress, some of you have a lot of appetite by eating chocolate, or some of you have lack of appetite. So another segment of POMC will produce the beta endorphin. So these beta endorphins are important because it can reduce your stress and maintain your homeostasis. Okay, go back to this ACTH segment of POMC. And this will stimulate this adrenal cortex to produce the cortisol hormone. So in the brain, cortisol acts on two types of receptor. Okay, one receptor we call it as a mineralocorticoid receptor, and another one is glucocorticoid receptor, or GR, as you can see here. Okay, so it is known that cortisol able to inhibit the secretion of CRH through glucocorticoid receptors, glucoreceptor complex in the hypothalamus and pituitary gland in a negative feedback cycle to downregulate the production of cortisol. That is why high level of cortisol will inhibit this HPA axis. Okay, another one, the secretion of aldosterone. Okay, aldosterone is the salt retaining hormone, primarily under the influence of circulating angiotensin and potassium. And this aldosterone, I believe that have been covered by Prof. Sabita lecture in the PhD 615 yesterday. Okay. As you can see here, the structure of adrenal gland consists of adrenal cortex, as another one is adrenal medulla. Okay. I would like you to focus on the adrenal cortex. Okay, the red color is the adrenal medulla. Okay. The adrenal cortex consists of three zones, which are the outer layer, known as zona globulosa, that is responsible to produce the mineralocorticoids, which is the aldosterone. The central layer, or known as zona fasciculata, responsible to produce cortisol, which is the natural glucocorticoids. And the last layer is the inner layer of the adrenal cortex, known as zona reticularis, which is responsible to produce the gonadocorticoids such as androgen and estrogen. As I mentioned earlier, ACTH that secreted by anterior pituitary gland will stimulate the adrenal cortex to convert the cholesterol in the body to form the adrenocorticosteroids. In humans, the most important mineralocorticoid is the aldosterone. Okay, this aldosterone, as I mentioned earlier, has been produced in the zona glomerulosa of the adrenal cortex. The further biosynthesis of pregnenolone and progesterone by cytochrome P17 enzyme of alpha hydroxylase will form the major glucocorticoids, which is the cortisol. As mentioned before, high level of cortisol will inhibit the secretion of ACTH. This mechanism is by the negative feedback of HPA axis. Dehydroepiandrosterone, or known as DHEA, is the major of the adrenal androgen. And androstenediol, as you can see in this diagram, is a potent estrogen. Androstenediol and androstenediol can be converted to testosterone and also estradiol in extra adrenal tissue in men and women respectively. I would like to highlight again, large number of steroids being produced by adrenal cortex into the circulations. Some of these having minimal biologic activity, which function as a precursor only. The rest that has biologic activity, we call it as hormonal steroid, that can be further classified as glucocorticoids, mineralocorticoids, and gonadocorticoids. Okay, as you can, let's recap back. Glucocorticoids having important effect on intermediary metabolism of protein and fat. Beside that, it also can be functioned as immune functions by reducing the antibody response and anti-inflammatory activity. The natural glucocorticoid is the cortisol, and the synthetic glucocorticoids, they're available in the hospital and market, known as hydrocortisone and corticosterone. Mineralocorticoids, which is the aldosterone, is principally exert the salt retaining activity, and the gonadocorticoids such as androgen and estrogen having the androgenic and estrogenic activity. So no worries, these two gonadocorticoids will be covered more the week after your test one by Dr. Zokapi and Madam Mazena. I believe that everyone still remember the catecholamine in your PHC513, which are the norepinephrine and epinephrine. These two neurotransmitters have been produced in the inner layer of adrenal gland, which is the adrenal medulla.